Hi there. In the previous video, we have solved the problems on grid and made a simulation to see all the paths that what are the different paths to reach the destination node. In the today's video, we will be solving the problem frog 1. This is easy problem and taken from AdCoder. The problem statement is there are n stones numbered 1, 2, 3, to n. For each I from 1 to n, the height of stone is hi. There is a frog who is initially on stone 1. He will repeat the following action some number of times to reach stone n, right? If the frog is currently on a stone i, jump to stone i plus 1 or stone i plus 2. That is, he can take at max 2 steps. Either he will jump 1 step or 2 step. Here a cost of hi minus hj is incurred. Okay, so if he is going from I plus 1, from I to I plus 1, then the cost incurred will be the difference of both the cost, where j is a stone to land on. Find the minimum possible total cost incurred before the frog reaches the stone n. Okay, so in this, frog can jump either 1 step or a 2 step, and we need to minimize the cost. That is, what is the minimum cost possible? So this is the symbol, or we can say that this is the statement which says us that we need to go for a dynamic programming solutions. Okay, the constraint for n is 10 to the power 5 and hi is 10 to the power 4, right? And input format is n is given and h1, h2 are the heights of the stone. So let us understand this through the test cases. So test case 1 is 4 stones are there. Initial stone cost 10, next 30, 40 and 20. Now to go from this step to the second step, he will cost 20, as the difference of 30 and 10 is 20. If he goes from this place to 40, it will cost him 30 rupees, or it will cost him 30, and from 30 he can go to 40 or 20, as from 10 he cannot move to 20, as at max he can take 2 steps. So let us simulate this. So here are the stones, stone 1, 2, 3 and 4 stones. 10, 30 and 40, 20. Now let us say that from 10 he take a step. So he takes a 1 step, and in 1 step he will reach with 30. If he takes 2 steps, he will go to 40, and from 30 he will have 1 step and 2 step. That is, he can take 1 step or 2 step, so he can reach 40 and 20, and from 40 he will have only 1 step, because if he take more than 1 step, he will outside the stone. So that is not the condition here. Just we need to the nth stone. So from 40 he can take only 1 step, which is this and this. These both are same. Okay, so the cost minimum, what is the minimum cost possible here? Like, if we take this path 10 to 30 and 30 to 40 and 40 to 20, then cost will be 20 plus 10, 30, 30 plus 20, 50. And if we take 30 and from 30 we take 2 steps to 20, so 20 plus 10, 30 would be the cost. If we take from this path, then it will be costing us 30 plus 20, which is 50, and so on. So how should we solve this problem? And in this, if we observe, then if we come at this position with optimal cost, that is the minimum cost, then from here to come at this position, if we take the minimum cost here, then we will get the minimum cost to reach at the 40. So to come at the kth position, if we have optimal cost t till k minus ith position, then for kth position also we will be getting the optimal path, optimal cost, right? So these are the substructure, or this we can call as sub problems, that if we solve this problem for k minus 1, we can use that solution to build it for the kth value. And for if we have kth solution, then we can go for k plus 1th solution, right? So let us solve this using DP. So the given cost is in an array 10, 30, 40, and 20, and the DP solutions which we will be framing have initialized value all with infinity, as we need to minimize the value, so initialization should be done with infinity. From 10 we can reach to 30, so the cost would be 20. From 10 we can reach 40, as at max 2 step we can take, so from 10 we can reach 40, which will cost 30 rupees. And that's done, that from 10 we can reach either 30 or 40. Now from 30 we can reach 40, so it will be 40 minus 30, which is 10. 10 plus 20 is 30 itself, so it is not getting minimized, so 30 will be here. From 30 we can move to 20, so 30 plus 20 is 10, and to reach at 30 we have incurred cost of 20, so 20 plus 10, 30. After that we have moved to positions from here also, that is 1 to 40 and another to 20. Now from 40 we have only one option, that we can move to 20. To move to 20, the difference of the cost would be 40 minus 20, which is 20. 20 plus 30 is 50, and 50 is greater than 30, so we will not change this one, as this is the minimum cost. After that we will reach at the 40, which is our destination position, right? And from here we get our cost to be 30, which is the minimum, and our solution will be DP of n minus 1 based on 0th based index. Like if we consider this as 0, 1, 2, 3, then DP of n minus 1 will be our solution, right? So this is a simple code, and we can extend this code for kth position also, that the frog can take 1 position, 2 position, 3 position to kth position, and it is very similar to the same one, and for which you will be solving in the practice questions. And we will be discussing if you have some problem with it. So the solution for this is given here. In 10, take the value of n. In the h vector, I am taking all the heights, and this is the dp which I am initializing with infinity. 1e 9 plus 5, which is equal to 10 to power 9 plus 5, and dp of 0 is 0. As to the initial path, we are already present in the initial cost, so we don't need to pay any cost for that. Now for dp of I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, that is iteration from this position to this position is getting done in the first for loop. And here I am initializing p to I, and j I p plus 1 and j less than p plus 3, because we can at most take 2 more steps, so it will run for p plus 1 and p plus 2, and the cost will be getting minimized, that if j is less than n, as we need to check for the upper bound also, that whether j is less than n or not, else we might get a segmentation fault error here. So dp of j equal to min of dp of j, the cost which is at this position, and dp of I, the cost required to reach at this position, that is this one, plus the difference of this. So we need to take the minimum of these two, and that will be the cost at dp of j, and our solution will be dp of n minus 1 to n. And here if we have two, if we take kth position, then here we can increment it like this: p plus 1 comma j semicolon j less than p plus k plus 1. That is kth step we can take, and we can minimize it in the same way as we have done in this problem. So hope that you have understood this problem well. And for you, we have a practice problem. This is frog 2 and a jumper problem, whose link is given in the description box. And if you face any problem in understanding or implementation, then do comment, we will help you out. And in the next lecture, we will look into the longest common subsequence problem. And until then, keep coding. Thank you for watching, and bye.